Hello everyone, you are on the Den Electro channel. And with you, as always, Dennis. Today there will be a small review on just such a board for homemade power banks. It is compact, powerful, and has all the necessary functions. There are two USB ports for charging gadgets. And for charging the power bank, a standard micro USB is used. On the website of the Aliexpress store where I bought this device, lithium-ion batteries of size 18650 are recommended. I don't see any logic in this. Therefore, in the future, I will use a flat lithium polymer battery. The minimum and maximum voltages of both types of batteries are the same. Therefore, they are interchangeable. There is nothing interesting on the front side of the board. Only monochrome LCD display and two battery terminals. At the back there is a button, three connectors, a white 5mm LED, and many SMD components. This chip is 5088SS. It monitors the maximum voltage of the batteries by driving them up to 4.2 volts and follow the minimum voltage. If the battery voltage drops to 3 volts while the phone is charging, the charging will stop. The second chip shows the display. She has no markings. Next is MP5043. We can say that the entire power bank rests on it. In fact, it is a step-up converter from 3 to 5 volts, but it still has some chips. It controls two USB ports and can deliver a maximum current of 2.4 amps. The outputs are protected against overload and short circuit. Batteries are charged with direct current and voltage. With the help of one button, it disconnects and connects the load, controls the flashlight, and has protection against overheating. If the board is connected to charging without a battery, it will start flashing quickly. When I connect the battery, the board turns onto normal operation. Charging starts immediately, and this is expressed as a battery charge. To turn on the board with the battery connected, hold down the button for a few seconds. This way you can check the battery charge. To send the power bank sleep mode again, you need to hold down the button again. To turn on the side LED, you need to quickly click on the button twice. It will be something like a flashlight. Only together with the LED, the display turns on. If the button is pressed twice again quickly, the LED will turn off. If you hold it down, the power bank turns off along with the flashlight. If the board is simply left on, then after 40 seconds, the backlight goes out. And after another 40, the power bank itself. The flashlight will burn indefinitely until the battery voltage drops to 3 volts. One of the outputs of the power bank is made for powerful devices. It should put out 5 volts with a current of 2.1 amps. The second connector is weaker. It is made for ordinary gadgets. Also produces 5 volts but with 1 ampere. If you hold down the button and turn off the power bank, then charging also stops. To resume charging, you need to hold down the button again. Without a flashlight and without backlight, the board's own consumption is 5 milliamp. If you turn it off, the consumption drops to 0. Therefore, the power bank can be stored for months, and the batteries will not run out. Of course, provided that they are good and they have a low self-discharge. And now I will show how the board behaves under load. And immediately it will be possible to calculate the efficiency. At idle, the output of the USB connector is 5 volts. We connect a 5 ohm resistor and the voltage sags a little and the current strength is 1 ampere. A very good indicator. instead of a battery, I supply voltage from the power supply. 3.7 volts, and consumption of 1.58 hundredths of an ampere. This is approximately 5.8 watts. And the output of the board is 5 watts. It turns out that the efficiency of the converter is around 86%. I'll check the second connector. Here I will connect nichrome spirals. This load turned out to be a bit insufficient. The current is only 1.7 amps, but the voltage has already dipped below 5 volts. Although this is enough to charge the phone. The efficiency here is slightly smaller, 82%. If you like this module for powerbank as much as I did, then you can buy it by clicking on the link in the description. That's all for today. Like this video if you liked it. And all for now.